PowerShell was added on Windows 7 onwards. Now PowerShell is a default choice in Windows 10. Microsoft introduced PowerShell in order to be able to compete with shells that are available in Linux systems. Hence, it's more complicated than command prompt. It is soon becoming the preferred scripting language for Windows system management. It uses pipes, which is very similar to Linux and helps to pass output from one command as an input into the other command. By the way, commands are called cmdlets in PowerShell. On the other hand, command prompt is a legacy environment used during the DOS command era and since been carried over with new Windows releases. Command prompt functions are limited compared to PowerShell. PowerShell uses different syntaxes as compared to command prompt, but it is still allows users to use command prompt commands by aliasing the syntax. So, I suggest you moving from the command prompt and start using PowerShell. Let's see some examples.
So, to start PowerShell, you need to right click on the start and then select PowerShell. We have two options. One, if you want to run it as admin, and the other as a normal. So let's run it as normal by clicking on it. Now to get all the commands that PowerShell provides us, all you need to type is get-command press enter. You can see here list of all the commands that PowerShell provides. And in the beginning, it gives a list of aliases. And each cmdlet is grouped according to a source or modules or class. So if you want the default option change from PowerShell to command prompt, all you need to do is to right click on your taskbar and click on taskbar settings. In the taskbar settings, click in here to replace command prompt with PowerShell. Turn that off, close this, and now if I right click, it will give me the result for command prompt. So if I select command prompt now, all I need to type is cmd space forward slash and a question mark and then enter. Here it gives us some explanation of how command prompt works. So if I press anything, we can continue and gives you more information. And if you want the list of all the commands, all you need to type is help, enter, and here it gives you all the list of the commands that are available. As you saw, PowerShell's list is much more extensive. Back to PowerShell, for example, now if I want to use a command prompt command by, for example, typing cdc:\ and then press enter, it will take me to the C drive directory by changing directory. But this is not an actual cmdlet of PowerShell, it's alias. So to get the alias, all you need to do is to type get-alias and then type the command that we just typed, which was cd, and press enter, and it shows that this is an alias, and the correct way of using it is by using set location. So if I want to use PowerShell default syntax, I will use set location c. Let's go to the users and press enter, and now we have changed the location by using set location instead of cd.
I hope this video was useful. If it was, please don't forget to watch my other videos on my left and to subscribe to support my channel. I hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye.